Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel Alisha Maths Classes. So today I have taken exercise 7.5 of class 12, which is based upon the chapter integrals. And in our previous video also we have discussed all the tricks of this exercise, and we have done up to question number 17 of this exercise 7.5. So today I am going to start from question number 18. But before that, those who have not seen our previous video for the solutions of question number 1 to 17, please click on the I link, and the description of remaining videos is given in the description box, so you can just click over there to check the videos. So without wasting the time, let's start from question number 18. So students, let's see question number 18, that is integration of x square plus 1 x square plus 2 upon x square plus 3 x square plus 4. So one thing we can just see here, that we're having the term x square in each of the term x in the numerator as well as denominator. So first of all, for our convenience, I'm going to replace x square by a new variable t. I'm not taking the differentiation. I am just replacing x square by a new variable t. So it will become t plus 1, t plus 2, t plus 3 into t plus 4. Remember here that integration will not change because it is with respect to x. I have not taken here differentiation, I have not replaced dx by a dt, so it will remain dx. Now one more thing you can observe here, that both the terms in the numerator as well as denominator is a quadratic equation. If you will simplify, you will get t square plus 3t plus 2 upon t square plus 7t plus 12. So I have discussed these type of questions, that whenever the degree of the numerator as well as denominator is same, we have to do long division, because we can do the integration only when the degree of numerator is less than denominator. So it becomes, so when I will divide t square by t square, I will get 1. So I will multiply by 1. T square into 1 becomes t square. 70 into 1 becomes 70. And 12 into 1 becomes 12. So just divide, I will get minus 4t minus 10. So that's it. Our formula, I have told you, that is q plus r upon d, that is quotient plus remainder upon divisor. So writing this expression in the form of quotient plus remainder, here quotient is 1 plus remainder is minus 40 minus 10 upon divisor. See, this is the divisor, but we don't have to write down in the form of quadratic equation, better to write down in the form of factors, because you know that further we have to use partial fraction method. Now split this integral into two parts. One is going to be 1 dx, and from these two terms you can take minus 2 common. So it is going to be 2t plus 5 upon t plus 3 t plus 4 dx. Mark this equation as 1 and just rub this, because this is a rough work you have to do. You have to do the long division whenever the degree of numerator and denominator are same, or whenever the degree of numerator is greater than denominator. So the integration of 1 with respect to x becomes x. And for this type of functions, you have done that by using partial fraction, we can integrate this function. So let's see how, either mark this equation 1, because we have done the integration of 1 with respect to x. Now we, by partial fraction, this 2t plus 5 upon t plus 3 into t plus 4 can be written as a upon t plus 3 plus b upon t plus 4. So simplifying it, by taking the LCM on both sides, I will get 2t plus 5 is equal to a into t plus 4. This is actually t plus 4. And this is b. Plus b into t plus 3. I have done the cross multiplication method. Now you know that if I will put t plus 3 is equal to 0, I will get t is equal to minus 3. So when I will put t is equal to minus 3, then I'll get 2 into minus 3 minus 6 plus 5, that is minus 1. Left hand side become minus 1. And if I'll put minus 3, minus 3 plus 3 becomes 0. So minus 3 plus 4 is going to be 1. So the value of A is equal to minus 1. Similarly, put T is equal to minus 4. As you will put T plus 4 is equal to 0, so you will get T is equal to minus 4. So 2 into minus 4 is going to be minus 8 plus 5, that is minus 3. So minus 4 plus 4 becomes 0, and minus 4 plus 3 is going to be minus 1. So that is minus B. So here I get the value of B is equal to 3. So just replace this value in equation number 1. So from equation 1 we get, x minus 2 times of, now this integration can be written in the this form, that is A, what is A here, that is minus 1 upon t plus 3 dx. See, here we are having dx. And what is B here? B is here 3. So 3 is a constant, you can take it outside, and integration of 1 upon t plus 4 dx. Now just open it, you will get minus minus plus. And now as the integration is with respect to x, so we have to replace the value of t here. For our convenience, we have put t is equal to x square. So just replace t by x square, and 3 can be written as root 3 whole square. Similarly, minus 2 into plus 3 is going to be minus 6. Minus 6 integration of replace t by x square, so it can be written as x square, and 4 can be written as 2 square. So both the terms are in the form of x square plus a square. So the integration of 1 upon x square plus a square is 1 upon a is here root 3, tan inverse x upon a, that is x upon root 3. Similarly, here we get 1 upon a is here 2, tan inverse x upon a, that is x upon 2, plus the constant of integration c. So the final answer is x plus 2 by root 3 tan inverse x by root 3 minus 2 can be cancelled by 6, so we are getting 3 tan inverse x by 2 plus c. Please note down. So student, this is question number 19, that is integration of 2x upon x square plus 1 x square plus 3. First of all, just see and check in the question that we are having a function and its derivative. Yes. So this is the function, x square is equal to c, we'll put x square is equal to t, so definitely 2x dx becomes dt, which is lying there in the numerator. So it becomes dt upon t plus 1 t plus 3. So using partial fraction, by partial fraction, we can write down this integral as, or we can just break this integral as a upon 1 t plus 1 plus b upon t plus 3. So just do the cross multiply, a into t plus 3 plus b into t plus 1. So same as it is, one time we have to put t is equal to minus 1, because if I'll put t plus 1 is equal to 0, I'll get t is equal to minus 1, and one time I will put t plus 3 is equal to 0, so I'll get t is equal to minus 3. Left hand side is not going to change as it is independent of t, it does not include t, so the value will remain same, that is 1. If I'll put minus 1 here, so minus 1 plus 3 is going to be 2a, so the value of a is equal to 1 by 2 here. And if I'll put t is equal to minus 3, so minus 3 plus 3 becomes 0, and minus 3 plus 1 is going to be minus 2b, so the value of b is equal to minus 1 by 2. So here I get the values of a and b. So just replace this value in equation number 1, so it becomes a is a constant, so better to take it outside, 1 by 2 integration of 1 upon t plus 1 dt. Again, b is also a constant, so better to take it outside, minus 1 by 2 integration of 1 upon t plus 3 dt. Now the integration of 1 upon t plus 1 is going to be log t plus 1 half log t plus 3 plus constant of integration c. Again, you can take half common. So I'm doing directly. It will become log m minus log n, which can be written as log m by n. So that is t plus 1 upon t plus 3 plus c. Finally, don't forget to put the value of t here. T is here x square. So x square plus 1 upon x square plus 3 plus c. So this is that simple. Note down. So students, let's see question number 20th. That is integration of 1 upon x into x raised to power 4 minus 1. Listen to me, students, very carefully. When students solve this type of question, they do a blunder in this question. They factorize this equation into two parts, that is x square plus 1 into x square minus 1, and further they split x square minus 1 by x plus 1 x minus 1. So in this way you are having five factors. Can you imagine? X square plus 1 and x square minus 1. So x square minus 1 can be further written as x plus 1 x minus 1. So there are total five factors, four factors, x plus 1 x minus 1. So if we will do that by partial fraction method, it will take a lot of time. So just see how to do this question. I know that the derivative of x raised to power 4 is 4x cube. So I have done this question in previous question also. So I'll just multiply and divide by the derivative in the form of derivative. So see how simple it becomes. It becomes x cube upon x cube into x becomes x raised to power 4 into x raised to power 4 minus 1. Yes, that is that simple. So just see here, we'll just put x4 is equal to t, that is x raised to power 4 is equal to t. Differentiating both sides, I'll get 4x cube dx is equal to dt. That is x cube dx is equal to 1 by 4 dt. So just replace here. I'll get 1 by 4, the value of x cube dx is dt, and it becomes t into t minus 1. So either you can use partial fraction method, I'm doing directly by hit and trial method. So I know that the coefficient is minus 1. So first of all, I will multiply both sides, outer and inner also by minus. It hardly matters. See. So I have taken minus inside and outside, because if we'll multiply it becomes positive, it will not affect. So now I will add t and subtract t. So t I have added and t I have subtracted. This is minus t. Without using partial, I can do or I can split this integral. If you are not convenient with this method, you can use our traditional method, that is partial fraction, to split this integral into two parts. I have split it with a very simple way by using hit and trial method. So just split this integral into two parts, t minus 1 upon t into t minus 1 dt, and finally minus t upon t into t minus 1. So minus can be taken outside, t upon t minus 1 dt. So just see what does it become. T minus 1 will be cancelled by t minus 1. It becomes 1 upon t dt. Similarly here t will be cancelled by t. It becomes 1 upon t minus 1 dt. So if I will integrate, I will get log t minus of log t minus 1 plus c. If I will insert negative inside, what do I get? I will get this term positive and this term negative. Now again it has been changed in the form of log m minus log n. So can be written as log m by n. M is here t minus 1 upon t plus c. So the final answer is 1 by 4 log. We have assumed t is equal to x raised to power 4. So x raised to power 4 minus 1 upon x raised to power 4 plus c. So this is answer. Please note down. So students, this is question number 21, that is integration of 1 upon e raised to power x minus 1. Although you can see here that there is only one factor in the denominator, so we can't do partial fraction, can't do anything. So just do like this, multiply by ex and divide by ex, fine, as we have done. because the derivative of e raised to power x is e raised to power x. Now just put e raised to power x is equal to t. So e raised to power x dx is equal to dt. So this becomes so simple question. E raised to power dx is equal to dt upon t into t minus 1. Again, as it is, so same we have done just previous question in question number 20. This is the same integral. I have taken negative outside and taken negative inside also without using partial and hit and trial method. So just added t and subtracted t to make the terms which is there in the denominator. Now split this integral into two parts. So one becomes t minus 1 upon t into t minus 1 dt, and other becomes minus minus plus integration of t upon t into t minus 1 dt. So finally, I am writing the integral containing positive sign firstly. So if I'll get cancel t by t, I'll get 1 upon t minus 1 dt. If I'll cancel t by t minus 1 by t minus 1, I'll get minus of 1 by t dt. So yes, this is this simple. So if I will integrate 1 upon t minus 1, I'll get log t minus 1 minus log t plus c, again in the form of log m minus log n, that is log m by n plus c. Finally, we have to replace the value of t, which is equal to e raised to power x. So answer is log e raised to power x minus 1 upon e raised to power x plus c. Please note down. So students, let's move on to question number 22. That is an MCQ question, but question is basically based upon partial fraction method. So let's see the solution. It can be written as, just do the step, hurry up. You can do this like this: a upon x minus 1 plus b upon x minus 2 by using partial fraction. Now just take the LCM. It will be equal to a into x minus 2 plus b into x minus 1. Now all of you know that we will put one time x is equal to 1 and one time we will put x is equal to 2. So we get here the value of, when we will put x is equal to 1, I will get here 1 is equal to a into 1 minus 2, that is minus 1. So I will get a is equal to minus 1. If I will put x is equal to 2 on both sides, that means 2, and 2 minus 1 is going to be 1. So the value of b is equal to 2. Using this in equation number 1, we get a is minus 1 upon x minus 1 dx plus 2 upon integration of 1 upon x minus 2 dx. So integration will be log x minus 1 plus 2 times log x minus 2 plus c. Now you know that m log n can be written as log m raised to power n. So it can be written as log x minus 2 whole square minus of log x minus 1 plus c. Now it is finally in the form of log m minus log n. So the answer is log x minus 2 whole square upon x minus 1 plus c. So this is our final answer. Just match. It is matching with part B. So the correct option is B. Please note down. Option is B. So student, this is the last question of exercise 7.5. That is integration of x upon x square plus 1. So you know that already it is in the form of factors. So by using partial fraction, it can be written as a upon x plus, as this is a quadratic, so we have to take a linear term in the numerator. So it will be bx plus c upon x square plus 1. So by taking LCM, it is going to be a into x square plus 1 plus bx plus c into x. So now just one time we'll put x is equal to 0. If I'll put x is equal to 0, see it, this equation becomes 0 and 0 plus 1 is going to be 1. So a into 1 is a. So this implies I'll get value of a is equal to 1. And finally, you know that x square plus 1 will not give any real value. So we have to do the comparison. We have to just open this equation. So when I will open this equation, the coefficient of x square I'm doing directly a plus b. Same, the coefficient of x will be cx. And finally, the constant term will be a. if I will compare, I can see that the value of C is going to be 0 because there is no term in the left hand side containing this term. And if I will compare, A plus B is equal to 0. So as here A is equal to 1, so that means B is equal to minus 1 here. Just put this value in equation number 1. So A is here 1 by x dx plus B is here minus 1. So minus 1 into x is going to be minus x. That is minus x upon x square plus 1. And C is finally 0. So don't need to write down. Now the integration of this 1 by x is log x. And you know that this is in the form of function. And in the numerator, it's derivative. Not exactly derivative. Just to make the derivative, we can take 2 multiplication and in division. So now you know that if I'll put x square plus 1 is equal to t. So that means 2x dx is equal to dt. So you can clearly see that 2x dx is there in the numerator. So just substitute the value 2x dx is equal to dt upon t. So the answer is log x minus half of log t plus c. So answer is log x minus half. The value of log t is x square plus 1 plus c. Correct answer is A option. Option A is correct. So students, here we have discussed all the topics of exercise 7.5 and how to solve the questions of partial fraction with a very simple manner. I hope that you like my video, and all the tricks that I have told in this video will definitely help you in your board exam. So if you like my video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching Alisha Maths Classes.